The children who are born deaf and dumb, that means they don't have any hearing, the child who is born with no hearing will not be able to speak because he is not hearing sound at all. And these children would then land up with absolute dumbness and they would not be able to do anything in terms of conversing with a normal human being. They would be limited to conversation only with their own peer group who are deaf and dumb with probably sign language. This was the scenario which was happening earlier. With the advent of cochlear implants, things have started changing, because now at this point in time we can transfer sound which is going in this ear, which is lacking hearing cells. They can still get stimulus because of the implant that is implanted in the ear, and then hearing can be interpreted as normally as the brain would interpret. This is what the cochlear implant looks like. This is the microphone and the speech processor. The sound is heard by the microphone, picked up by the microphone, sent to the speech processor, which makes this into small clips, which is passed through this coil into the implanted part of the cochlear implant, which is the receiver stimulator, which is under the skin. And that receiver stimulator is stimulated by this coil. The sound is processed by the speech processor through the coil to pass through the radio waves into the receiver stimulator, and that receiver stimulator then passes the sound into the electrode array, which is inserted into the cochlea by the surgical technique. And this is what how the speech is then transferred through the electrode array, which stimulates the remnant of the hair cells and the nerves thereon, and pass that sound through the electrical impulses into the cochlear nerve, into the brain, and which is interpreted by this child now. So this is where the bypass has occurred. The electrode array is now playing a key role in listening to the sounds and transferring it to the brain.
After the operation, after the implantation of cochlear, I think she is quite normal as the other children. And the hearing is improving day by day. It's just like normal hearing, we can say. And her speech is also, you know, very clear now. Very, very clear now. We can easily understand what she's saying. No problem at all. Even in the class, she's doing good. Very good.
आप मम्मा को बोलते हो, मम्मा आपको स्कूल में क्या देती है लंच में?
मैगी. रोज मैगी लेके जाते हो? रोज.
अच्छा, आपकी फ्रेंड का नाम क्या है क्लास में?
सनाया.
Okay, और आपकी टीचर का नाम क्या है?
दीप्ति मैम.
अच्छा काशु, पापा की कार का कलर क्या है?
रेड.
वेरी गुड. अच्छा अच्छा, मम्मी ने जो टॉप पहना है, मम्मी के टॉप का कलर क्या है? ये ब्राउन कलर.
ब्राउन. शिप माय ब्लू शिप सेलिंग इन द वाटर लाइट का तो साथ था.
वेरी गुड.
A very important population who are hearing impaired is the elderly population. With families getting new cochlear, the elderly are left alone to fend for themselves. And especially if it is a single elder who is staying alone. Imagine a person who cannot hear because of aging process, which we call as presbyacusis. These people, if they are staying alone, cannot hear alarms, they cannot hear sounds like bell, a telephone ring, and they cannot communicate with their own peer group. With the result, they get excommunicated, self-excommunicated by the society, and they start having a reclusive life, which is very depressing for an elderly. And they can't hear the television has to be made very loud, which disturbs the neighbors and other people who are staying around. And so it's a situation which is not very healthy, and these people have to be taken care of in terms of communication issues, and they have to be made part of society so that they can communicate with their people around. They can go about doing their work all alone because they are staying alone, and hearing aids play a major role here. And hearing aids are now getting better and better with passage of time. They're getting digitalized and it's more sophisticated, and you use both the ears so that they can get sound, not only sound but also direction to the sound. They can hear where the sound is coming from. They will not miss alarms, they will not miss telephone bells, they will not miss talking to their friends and relatives, and they will not be excommunicated in a community where they have to be a part and parcel of this society.
Welcome to the world of Amplifon. Amplifon, as you know, not only provide audiology services, but we are here in India to provide the right need for each child going through the implant program. Our implant programs are very, very customized to the need of a child. We work very closely with the surgeons, with the doctors, to ensure that the audiology and surgery goes hand in hand. The pre and the post surgery requirements are being taken care for all the children, and these pre and post surgeries are being provided with the right intent so that the child comes to the normality and starts speaking really fast. Our speech therapy programs are specially designed according to the need and customized according to the need of individual children, and that really brings a huge difference in the way a child starts responding to all the implant surgery programs. The rehabilitation, as we know, is as important as surgery, or in some cases we have seen that when you are not provided the right rehabilitation to the children don't respond to surgery alone. And therefore there is a need for a surgery to be complemented with the right rehabilitation program. And you can completely bank on us for providing the right speech therapy and rehabilitation program for your children. We want to be friends to your child so that he understands and works with us, so that he picks up the right speech that is required to live life normally like any one of us. And we help every children to do that very successfully. Thank you.